welcome to a quick and dirty video about how I actually handle the MMC card in this system. You'll note that I've actually got a small protrusion out of here, which is where the MMC card is sitting, and that is how it's installed. I'm going to post a link to the seller, because he's selling these on eBay, and I'll just put that up there. And it consists of a basic piece of equipment here that converts the SD card, or rather the MMC card to be correct, and allows it to go via the user port. The other part is a modified DFS, which is on an EEPROM, so just install that in a free slot and you should be pretty much aware to go. In order to install the cable, it's in the user port, but you've got to notice that there's a screw hole right behind it. So when you put this in and you're running it under the motherboard like I've done, in order to pop it up here, you've got to miss that screw port. And then it just comes up the side and away you go. And you can attach it like that. Actually getting this in wasn't too difficult. What I did was install the pads. I didn't take the sticky off them, but I just put it in position. Then it was a matter of using a pencil to line around where this goes. Take the thing away, and then drill holes at each end. On the other side, if I take that out, I then got a ruler, drew a line between the two points, and then drilled other holes to make the joint. Then with a model file, I filed it down, inside and outside, and then I was free to rip the sticky off the back of these and install it permanently. And in goes the MMC card. Nice and straightforward. I'll sound a warning now that if you buy this, you need to use MMC cards. SD cards are no good. I mean, that's one reason why I had problems, because I was using SD cards and it didn't like it. We're going to come later on as to how to use this and the commands to control it. That's going to be a section on its own. But that is the basics of how to install the MMC nice tidily in your B. One other thing I had to do was take about 4 inches off the ribbon. Now the seller I think he'll do this for you if you ask. I think it was about 4 inches. It's the length of about 6 function keys, but that had to come off in order to avoid too much ribbon in the case. If you've got some IDE cables yourself, you know, the old kinds of things, then you might want to practice doing it yourself if you're comfortable. And if you muck it up, then ask him to do the length adjustment for you. That's how it's installed, quick and dirty. I hope that helps you.